friends, and welcome to the celebration of our Sunday worship at Our Lady and All Angels Liberal Catholic Church in Omaha, California. Before our Eucharist begins this morning, please join with me in homage to Our Lady. Mother name, all holy, throned upon thy knee, evermore the almighty child and Lord we see. While with awe thou gazest on that wondrous face, blessed among all women, Mary, full of grace. We bow in homage and adoration to thee, our Heavenly Mother, Queen of the heavens, Star of the sea, Guardian of humanity. We greet thee and thine angel hosts, shedding beauty and blessing among men and in nature. May we serve thee in our fellow man. O Holy Lady, Mother of the world, Queen of love and of compassion, with all our hearts we pour out our love and devotion at thy feet, and we offer ourselves as channels of thy wondrous tenderness, as agents of thy never-ready help. We pray thee to use us in thy holy work, that we may grow like thee, our glorious Mother. O Holy Mother, Queen of our hearts, we dedicate our lives to thy service. Ave Maria, gratia plena. Angels and archangels now around the Maid, where the world's Creator upon her knees is laid, where she worships for him, God and man in one, Son of highest heaven, Mary's royal Son. Amen. Thank you.
May the Lord purify me that I may worthily perform his service. In the strength of the Lord do I repel all evil from this his holy altar and sanctuary, and from this house wherein we worship him. And I pray, Father, that he will send his holy angel to build for us a spiritual temple through which his strength and blessing may be poured forth upon his people through Christ our Lord. Brethren, let us now lay the foundation of our faith. Christ is our foundation and our chief cornerstone. We are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto a holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Except the Lord build the house, their labor is lost but building. The foundation of God stand sure, having this seal, let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Christ is our foundation and our chief cornerstone. O Lord, thou hast created man to be immortal, and made him to be an image of thine own eternity. Yet often we forget the glory of our heritage and wander from the path which leads to righteousness. But thou, O Lord, hast made us for thyself, and our hearts are ever restless till they find their rest in thee. Look with the eyes of thy love upon our manifold imperfections, and pardon all our shortcomings, that we may be filled with the brightness of the everlasting light, and become the unspotted mirror of thy power and the image of thy goodness, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Praise and with prayer shall our temple be built.
With God alone be the glory.
The epistle is taken from the fifth chapter of the Epistle of St. Paul. say that, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that you cannot do things that you would. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Here ended the epistle. Thanks be to God. He that loveth wisdom loveth light, and they that seek her early shall be filled with joy. Teach me, O Lord, the way of thy statute, and I shall keep it unto the end. Give me understanding, and I shall keep thy law. Yea, I shall keep it with my whole heart. The path of the just is as a shining light, shining more and more into the earth of day. Cleanse my heart and my lips, O God, and by the hand of thy servant didst cleanse the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal from thine altar. And in thy loving kindness, so purify me that I may word to proclaim thy holy gospel through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
May the Lord be in my heart and upon my lips, that through my heart the love of God may shine forth, and through my lips his power be made manifest.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is taken from the 16th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Mark, beginning at the 9th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord. Now when Jesus was risen early the first day of the week, if a man loves me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. He that keepeth not my sayings loveth me not. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your ideal concepts and qualities, we may somehow grow a little closer to the experience of God realization. The mystical approach to spirituality consists of teachings which are meant to help. Finite mortals understand their relationship with their Creator, whose nature is believed to be unlimited, immeasurable, and transcendent. We believe that understanding existence in this world and relationships we have in this life and the relationship between things in this created world which exists is a path to spiritual attainment. One of God's names in Scripture is Yahweh Shalom, which means the Lord is peace. The Hebrew word for peace, shalom, means wholeness of life, completeness, welfare, safety. God certainly is the source of all these blessings, but more importantly, and to our purpose this morning, to gain an understanding, we consider that the very nature of God himself, itself, is peace. This morning, in the Gospel, Christ explains his relationship with his Father as being completely united with him in oneness. Further, Christ explains that our relationship with the transcendent Father is through him, the Christ nature within. Now Jesus gave his disciples this truth based on the fact that he himself had overcome the world. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world. So certainly as we look around in this day and this time, this very unique time in which we live, with the COVID-19 and all of the information that we're being given and inundated with, and with social unrest, and with our attention's being brought to the fact of injustice and inequality, with the concomitant financial insecurities that comes with an economy which has been impacted, the high rate of unemployment, relationship challenges, and broken lives and broken homes, perhaps even on a personal level, depression. All of these things will happen, will be part of this experience in which we find ourselves. But this is a world of duality. This is a world of change, of constant change. The one thing we know through all of these things is this too shall pass. But the reality of the spiritual nature within each one of us is eternal, immutable, unchanging, and is at complete and total peace. Jesus says, my peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as this world gives peace. Do not let your hearts be troubled, do not be afraid. And the promise that we find in the 26th chapter of Isaiah is as true today as when the prophet himself wrote these words, you will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon you. And so, peace is the fruit of the Spirit. If we're allowing the Spirit of God to rule and manifest in our lives, we will experience this peace. To be spiritually minded brings life and peace. Every Mass, the final benediction that we invoke, peace that passes all understanding, understanding of that peace takes a strong, resolute faith and confidence that no matter what circumstances we may encounter, God is good, God will keep us, God provides for us, and God is peace. And now unto God the Father, God the Son, Holy Ghost, three persons in one God, be ascribed as is most justly due, all might, majesty, power, and dominion, now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen. Let us continue our worship with the act of faith. We believe that God is love and power and truth and life, that perfect justice rules the world, that all his sons shall one day reach his feet, however far they stray. We hold the fatherhood of God, the brotherhood of man. We know that we do serve him best when best we serve our brother man. So shall this blessing rest on us, and peace forevermore. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
We adore thee, O God, who art the source of all life and goodness, and with truth, thankful hearts. We offer unto thee this token of thine own life-giving gifts bestowed upon us, thou who art the giver of all. According to immemorial custom, we now mix water with this wine, praying thee, O Lord, that we may evermore abide in Christ, and he in us. We offer unto thee, O Lord, this chalice with joy and gladness. May the worship which we offer ascend before thy divine majesty, as a sacrifice pure and acceptable in thy sight, through Christ our Lord. answer us before thee, O Lord, so that our prayer be set forth in thy sight. Let thy holy angels encompass thy people and breathe forth upon them the spirit of thy blessing. May the Lord enkindle within us the fire of his love and the flame of everlasting charity. Built a temple for the distribution of Christ's love. Now let us prepare a channel for its reception. And to that end, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable unto God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord receive the sacrifice of thy hands in his service.
We lay before thee, O Lord, these thy creatures of bread and wine, linking them spiritually with ourselves, and pray thee to receive through them our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. For here we offer and present unto thee ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a holy and continual sacrifice unto thee. May our strength be spent in thy service, and our love pour forth upon thy people, thou who livest forever. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Yes, and to our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting Father. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with thrones, dominations, virtues, powers, with cherubim and seraphim, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. O Lord, these celebrations have served as tokens and channels of our love and devotion toward thee, but now we pray thee to receive, to purify, and to hallow them. As earthly channels of thy wondrous power, we desire to offer this holy sacrifice, especially for thy holy Catholic Church, for Donald Trump, the President of these United States, and all that are put in authority under him, for all of our bishops, clergy, and faithful, for those here present, and for all whom this transitory life are in trouble. Sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially evermore praising thee in word and deed, O God, everlasting, living, and true. Wherefore, Holy Lord, Father Almighty, we pray thee to look down on and accept as a channel these offerings, and with thy Holy Spirit and word, to bless, approve, and ratify them, that they may become for us the most precious body and blood of thy Son, who the day before he suffered took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and with his eyes lifted up to heaven and to thee, God his Almighty Father, giving thanks to thee, he blessed, break, gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat to you all of this, for this is my body. Supped, taking also this noble chalice into his holy and venerable hands, again giving thanks unto thee, he blessed it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and drink ye all of this, for this is my blood, as oft as you shall do these things, you shall be them in remembrance of me. With these heavenly gifts, Christmas feast, do thou hallow, quicken, and bless them with both in their hearts and their lives, and they show forth thy praise and glorify thy holy name. All these things we ask, O Father, in the name and through the mediation of thy most blessed Son. For we acknowledge and confess with the hearts and lips that by him were all things made, yea, all things both in heaven and earth. With him, as the indwelling life, do all things exist, and in him, as the transcendent glory, all things live and move and have their being. To whom with the Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be ascribed all honor and glory throughout the ages of ages. Let us pray, instructed by the words of sacred scripture and following the tradition of Holy Church from of old, we now say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Here we give unto thee, O Lord Most High, praise and heartfelt thanks for the wonderful grace and virtue declared in the Holy Lady Mary, our Heavenly Mother, and in all thy glorious saints from the beginning of the world. You have been the choice vessels of thy grace and the shining light unto many generations. And we join with them in worship before thy great white throne, whence flow all love and light and blessing to all the worlds which thou hast made. O Son of God, who showest thyself this day upon a thousand altars, and yet art one and indivisible, in token of thy great sacrifice, we break this thy body. Praying that by this action, ordain it from of old, thy strength, thy peace, and thy blessing, which thou dost give us in this holy sacrament, may be spread abroad upon thy world. And as thou, O Lord Christ, was made known to thy disciples in the breaking of bread, so may thy many children know themselves to be one in the world, even as thou art one with the Father. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
In this adorable sacrament hath left us a living memorial and pledge of thy marvelous love for mankind, and dost therein graciously draw us into wondrous and mystic communion with thee. Grant us so to receive the sacred mysteries of thy body and blood, that our souls may be lifted into the immensity of thy love, and that being filled with a high endeavor, we may ever be mindful of thy indwelling presence and breathe forth the prayers of our holy life. that and partake of the body of the Lord, draw nigh and receive this most holy sacrament.
And with thy spirit.
blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
May the Holy Ones, whose pupils you aspire to become, show you the light you seek, give you the strong aid of their compassion and their wisdom. There is a peace that passeth understanding, divides in the hearts of those who live in the eternal. There is a power that maketh all things new. It lives and moves in those who know the self as one. May that peace brood over you, that power uplift you, until you stand where the one initiator is invoked to you.